Hello. Have anyone of you guys have heard of this project called OpenROV? Oh, okay. So in general, I would just okay. So generally, OpenROV is actually is an open source underwater drone. But you know, you can actually build your own simple ROV, and you can actually control it on the Chrome web browser, and you actually can. So in tonight's session, I'll just be sharing my so-called like my journal and my adventures of why and how I, kind of like built on this OpenROV. So I'll start with the why first. Why did I even start this project? Because I mean, I don't know whether most of you have any like diving license or have done underwater exploration. So because of that, that kind of led me to the curiosity of to like find out what is actually underneath. I mean, in the ocean, under the water. So because of that, one of the problems is because at the moment, underwater diving, if you do not have the skills, it's going to be a bit troublesome. You don't have the ability to do it. Then if you do have it, it's going to be a bit expensive, because you need to get the equipment and so on, and so it's going to add up to unnecessary costs. So I thought, why can we actually, how can I actually kind of like create something which, to do something to explore underwater? So the solution was to build myself a low-cost drone. Yeah, I mean underwater drone. So actually, this as you can see over here is actually is based on three thrusters. It has two horizontal thrusters and one vertical thrusters. And actually, it has it's tethered to a computer, and you can actually control it using simple controls on the keyboard. And it provides live video feedback using onboard webcam inside the drone itself, and it's battery operated. So actually, there's no power transmission across the tethered cable. It's just video signals, and actually, it's just powered by six cells of battery in the drone. So this is actually more of the build process. So the parts are actually built mainly of acrylic parts, where you can actually laser cut it. And most of the parts I got was off-the-shelf hobby parts. I mean, these are actually brushless motors. Then you assemble them, and coming from the electronics point of view, it's actually there was actually three main PCBs. First is actually the light board, whereby you actually gives luminance in deeper depths, followed by a microcontroller board. That one provides control signals to the three thrusters. So actually, you can see over here, this part here essentially is the microcontroller. Then coupled with actually another microprocessor that is actually is using the BeagleBone board. So that does the video processing from the USB webcam. So over here is from the back side, you can actually see this is actually the BeagleBone board being sandwiched above the controller board. You can see a bunch of cables over here. Actually, it's not really very neat, but I didn't want to. I just tried to squeeze as much as I can into a small little enclosure. So this was me trying to test out whether I could get any live feed from the camera onto the computer itself. Then finally, once it's all assembled, you can see actually it's pretty small. It fits into a quite handy Pelican case, and you can see in the middle over here, right, it's actually the entire completed assembled drone, whereby it's actually housed or encapsulated in an aluminium shell. Then at the back, you can see this orange float. Because what happened was the first time I did a so-called test dive, I realized that it wasn't neutrally buoyant; it was actually positively buoyant. So what happened was it sank. Yeah, actually, so actually by right, the principle is you're supposed to achieve neutral buoyancy. So actually, you do not have to control the depth of the drone. You can actually hover at whatever depth you're bringing in. So that was after tweaking.
Were you using a dive plane, or how are you trying to control it?
Using the vertical thrusters, so you can actually control the depth by just altering, pressing on the vertical thrust. So this is to give you a size comparison, actually. So that's an iPhone 5 compared to the drone itself. So it actually is quite small. So what happened was, I actually after having it brought it to a test dive in a pool. I actually brought it to Bedok Reservoir, and yeah. So unfortunately, I don't have any videos or photos because I was quite excited back then. So yeah, I was still excited, like, you know, couldn't just wait to try it out in the reservoir. So long story short, I was a bit disappointed with what there was in the reservoir because what you can see is only actually a very murky water. It's all plainly, I mean, very greenish, very brackish. Didn't get to see the kind of underwater life I kind of imagine in my mind. Yeah. So this is in a nutshell. This is what Open Ocean Reef is about. So what's next? So next is actually to it's another. It's like a build on upon the first ROV. So actually, the next one is actually to use is to build a 6 DOF drone. So instead of having 3 thrusters, you have actually 6 thrusters, of which you have 2 horizontal, 3 vertical, and 1 thruster. So this gives you a higher degree of control in terms of attitude. You can actually now, besides doing the normal going forward, reverse, turning on your spot, and up and down, you can actually start to do more of a yaw and pitch, because with the additional three vector controls, 3 thrusters, it gives you a greater degree of manipulation of the entire bearing of the drone itself. So how's it going to be controlled? So what you can see over here actually is a very rough schematic plan. So on the left side, you can actually see more of the surface control, whereby this is going to be a tethered drone again. But on the left side is going to be controlled on board using Q ground control. Actually, it's a software whereby a lot of hobbies have used it, not only just for drones. They say is it. I mean, not just for underwater drones. They say is it for quadcopters, as well as for normal RC drones. Then on the downside, the bottom side of the drone itself, actually is going to be controlled using a Pixhawk, whereby it has actually it's been used for a lot of quadcopters in the market. But what you can actually do is it can actually increase the number of so-called thruster controls on board this Pixhawk, and then thread with all the normal ESCs, battery packs, and lastly, it's actually over here actually is going to be connected to a sort of like a camera module, so that you can have a wireless. I mean, you can have a video transmission. So what I've done so far is actually just mainly build the mechanical structure. So most of the thrusters, the enclosure, the so-called the chassis all built up. So the next actually is to be left with the integration electronic control system. So at the moment, this project has taken a short break. So if anyone among you who's interested in, you know, like having some ideas to test upon it, I'm always, you know, I'm welcome for any kind of hacking or collaboration. Yeah, so that's open our ROV for you guys. Anyone has any question? Yep.
So you use like multiple thrusters to go different directions. Has anyone ever tried a single thruster which rotates to move the thing?
Has anyone tried? It's going to with one thruster, you're going to have. I don't know if it's possible, because to have only one thruster, you're going to be at the influence of the currents. So it's going to be a bit hard to actually control your directional control. Yeah.
Instead of just using thrusters, maybe using flaps or fins or flaps also make it more cost efficient.
That could be another idea. So actually, what I was thinking as well was instead of using more thrusters, I can actually reduce the thrusters and have more of like servo controls to kind of like mimic how fish, dolphins swim. Yeah.
Waterproofing, that is always a problem.
Yeah.
How? Because you need to have a motor that's inside that's waterproof.
Yeah.
And a shaft outside that's not waterproof, because the fin is attached to the shaft.
Right. Mm.
So you have to bring the waterproof barrier with some kind of a
linkage.
Seal or linkage. And that just generally gets very...
It's going to be messy. Yeah.
How deep can it go?
Okay, so Bedok Reservoir is I googled online how deep, so it's 18 meters deep. So, but based on other people who has actually built, they said they've tested up to 100 meters. So I can't really, I have not tried that yet. Yeah, but at the moment, it's as deep as 18 meters. Yeah. You have a go ahead.
But then, if you change your depth, your buoyancy will
change. Because this depth, right, is not deep enough, because at 18 meters is still so far is
six.
Sorry?
No.
Atmospheric pressure, is it?
Yeah, it's one atmosphere per 10 meters.
Yeah.
Okay. So two atmospheres.
Three atmospheres, that's it.
You double your buoyancy.
Yes.
Because what I did was also added lead weights, coin weights at the front of the thrusters over here, so that actually kind of compensate for the initially when it was just without the orange flotation, it was just sinking, so I had to actually kind of like trim the buoyancy by adding more of the orange float at the back. Yeah.
So what I'm saying is, when you go deeper, mm-hmm. you'll become more positive.
Then you'll try to float. They will try to
float. You'll try to float. Yeah.
Have you considered adding a bladder?
I have, but it was it's going to be a bit complex in terms of the control system, because to add bladder means you must have either a pneumatic valve, and that includes more control. Then it makes the entire so-called like the control system of it trying to adjust the relative buoyancy as it goes deeper a bit I would say complicated.
Technically, you don't need particle thrusters.
Unless you intend to just stay hover and observe what's happening. I mean, if you choose not to have that, yeah.
You say it's no power, so it's only like a USB.
Maybe I'll go there in a bit detail. So actually, what happens over here, right? So you can see over here, right? This little container beside the reel, actually. So. What happens is actually how you actually squeeze or so-called like converge a normal Cat 5e cable to a two core cable was actually those home plugs where you try to extend the Wi-Fi range of internet. So what I did was I bought this brand called TP-Link. You open it up. What you do is you take the parts where it's supposed to connect it to the router. So those parts are actually the ones that actually help to convert the signals from a normal Cat 5e to a normal two-core power line, so that you can actually extend transmission using a power line instead of having install your Cat 5e cables around the house. So that's the same thing. So actually there is two parts of it. On the receiving end on the surface is kept inside this container. So within the drone within the drone itself is actually. Attached inside the electronic chassis. So actually, I can't really show you, but actually, okay. So if you see over here, right, there's this BeagleBone. The BeagleBone is actually a microprocessor. Then, in between the BeagleBone and the Arduino controller board, it's actually whereby you can actually have that the other PCBs sandwiched in between. So actually, there are so-called another additional wire that is coming from the BeagleBone itself that actually connects to that TP Home Link PCB. Then from then on, right, you actually connect using the two core tethered wire all the way up to the surface. Then it kind of like it re-expands back to the normal Cat 5e cable. So what you can actually see is
the laptop.
Yeah. Yeah. What I did was just drop this drone with the wire into the water. So the rest, that means the reel plus this converter and the laptop on the surface. So actually, what happened is to operate it first, actually you have is so called battery. It kind of you have to so called power up the machine using the USB itself. So what happens first you plug in the USB, and after plugging USB you kind of like activate the entire PCB inside the drone itself. Then at the same time you plug in your Cat 5 cable to your computer. Then on the computer itself, right, because you have to actually change your IPs to just do your local area. So then that from down usually it's more like it acts like an IP camera of sorts. Yeah.
And on the
bigger
board you have a G-streamer that stream the video.
Yeah, correct. Yeah. So so you stream the video, correct, yeah.
Let's say to 80 meter in Veda Reservoir, yeah. Even after a few meters the light is already very attenuated.
Correct, yeah. So what happened?
Do you have some light into the
correct. So that's why there's a light board on board here. So actually over here, right? Because of as you go deeper it gets darker, dimmer. So what happened, you can actually control the brightness of this LED on board from the top surface itself. So you can have the ability to either switch it on and off and to control its brightness as well.
When you go like this and you take videos,
yeah.
certain color actually are attenuated more than others.
Correct, okay.
The, So afterwards, maybe sometimes the light, it's not actually white light.
Yeah. So based on from the LED, the light, the LED board is actually it's a very
warm color light. Yeah. So like what you said, as you go deeper, depending on the visibility and the depth of the sea of the lake for this matter, I mean for the reservoir for this matter, it will definitely affect the color, the color view on the screen itself. Yeah.
So apart from the Veda reservoir, where will you plan to go?
Okay, so that's a good question. So
St. John's Island or some place like this.
Yeah,
it's
correct.
Quite some nice area.
Yeah, so yeah, my next so-called goal is to try Lazarus St. John Islands. Yeah. Yeah, I understand actually there's the Tropical Marine Science Institute is located on called Lazarus Island. So they have a kind of like a marine park of sorts near Sisters Island. So that will be like the next goal.
Is it feasible to do the control wirelessly?
Oh yeah. Okay, wirelessly. Not underwater. So what other people have actually does, right? They created like a buoy. So what happened is actually the theater itself. So that means this reel is actually being on a floating buoy. But between this computer and that so-called the converter, they can actually link it wirelessly. Yeah, that's possible. But not between directly from your surface computer to your underwater drone for now. But Chinmay has something. Yeah, you can. He's working on underwater wireless communication. So he's the go-to guy for that. Yeah, I mean seriously. Someday.
We'll be able to provide you with
the infrastructure. Yeah.
It's like a TP link.
Yeah.
Or some theology part of the doctors, and I was just putting them about the tour.
Okay.
And their comment was pull request or it didn't happen.
Sorry?
Pull request or it didn't happen.
Or it didn't happen. So the question is, are you actually using stock algae part or are there catches on top of
that? I'm using a stock. Yeah. So it's direct stock from open out from if you go to their GitHub, it's a stock.
Okay.
Any more questions? Yeah.
Have you thought of adding an arm?
Yeah, manipulators are one thing which is a bit finicky because some people on the forum have tried adding manipulators. So it was a bit finicky because as you go deeper, right, it tends to, first of all, mechanical flux. It just did not respond to what was instructed. And the next thing is so because of the addition of the manipulators, right, when you try to pick up something, because of the translation of your COG, it affected the stability. So when they try to pick up an object, what happened you can imagine. So it starts to get heavy on the bow side, and then when you try to actually move it, it's a bit precarious. So, I considered adding a manipulator, but for now my next goal actually is more of creating the 6DOF. Drone, because what happened was I did see a couple of people who actually created a 6DOF drone. It was very nimble, so I like the fact that you can actually have a greater degree of control in terms of you can actually, instead of just doing the normal very static forward, reverse, up and down, you can actually start to do banks and pitches and yaws. Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay. Welcome.